Welcome to part 5 of this video series. We're kicking off by looking at RPMs. If you've used Cisco's SLAs before, you'll be familiar with the concept. In short, we're going to see how to configure Junos to monitor a path or endpoint for uptime or performance. RPMs measure network-level performance between two endpoints. They can monitor metrics like packet loss, response time, round-trip time, and jitter. They do this by sending probes from a source device to a target. The target can either be an IP address or a URL, and the probe can be ICMP, TCP, UDP, or HTTP, depending on what you're trying to measure. Some of the probes, such as ICMP probes, are very simple. They only need to be configured on the source end. More complicated probes require additional configuration on the target endpoint. One or more probes are grouped together into a test. Probes within a test are sent out at regular intervals, and when all probes are finished, the test is considered complete. At this point, the test restarts and runs again. Statistics are returned for each test. So let's not waste any more time. Let's see this in action. We'll create a simple probe that will monitor the availability of our default gateway using ICMP. These are configured under Services and RPM. The first thing to set is the owner. Traditionally, we might use this to assign an RPM to a customer. This further shows Juniper's service provider history. We'll just use this as a name and call it PingGW. Now we'll configure a test called ICMP and set the probe type. There's a few probe types available, but ICMP ping will suit us just fine. Now for the rest of the parameters. We want to send 10 pings, 3 seconds apart. The gateway is our target, which is 192.168.200.254. This starts operating the moment we commit these changes. You'll also notice that this platform requires a license for RPMs. However, they'll still work without a license for the purposes of testing in the lab. Of course, you will need to see the results of the test, which you can do with Show Services RPM Probe Results. This shows us the owner, which is basically the name of the probe, the test, which may bundle a few probes together, the type, which for us is a simple ping, and the results, which for us is successful. We can see that a response has been received. A feature that's relatively new to Junos is route tracking. This is something that Cisco have had for a long time and Junos are catching up with. This was introduced in Junos 18.4 on the MX router platform. The idea is that we can link the results of an RPM to a static route. The static route is considered valid as long as the RPM is working. If the RPM returns a failed result, the static route is then removed from the routing table. We'll try this in the lab, so if you're interested, head over to the website and check it out. RPMs are very useful. I especially like the option of route tracking. In fact, if you want to see that in action, have a look at the lab that goes along with this video. We're continuing to look at monitoring and troubleshooting in the next and final video of the series. So click this video and join me there.